With increased cases of COVID-19 affecting various parts of the world, it's time to talk about the upcoming COVID-19 booster available in the later part of 2024 and the beginning part of 2025. Now, this vaccine booster is expected to target the KP.2 variant, and that's different than last year's strain, which targeted the XBB variant. It's also expected to be monovalent, meaning that it will only target that KP.2 variant. And that's different than 2 years ago where you heard the term bivalent because that was targeting the original strain and the Omicron strain. Now, in the US, it's expected that there will be three different types available, two of them being mRNA-based, and those would be available first, and then a few weeks later having the protein-based vaccine available. Now, as a quick refresher, let's talk about how these different vaccines actually work. Now, they're all targeting that spike protein that's found on the outside of SARS-CoV-2, and that's been going through rapid mutations over the last several years due to its constant infections in different people. So what researchers have done is isolated out the genetic material of the spike protein, specifically the mRNA, and then encapsulated that inside of a lipid nanoparticle. Now that mRNA provides the instructions to make the KP.2 variant form of the spike protein. When that's added into a vaccine and administered to an individual, the lipid nanoparticle is able to fuse with our cells. Those mRNA instructions are delivered to our cells, and then our cells can make that KP.2 variant spike protein. Our immune system recognizes that it shouldn't be there, and we create immunity against it. Now, the protein-based vaccines work a little bit differently in the beginning, as those proteins are actually grown in the lab, and they're combined with a specific adjuvant known as ASO1 to help boost our immune response. They're then formulated into a vaccine, injected into an individual, and then our immune system can directly interact with those KP.2 variants of the spike protein and create an immune response. So make sure you stay connected with us to learn more about infectious diseases, vaccines, and other health topics.